Hello and welcome to Let's Play Cyberpunk 2077 Blind. I'm Amethyst Unitari.
Yesterday's body count lottery rounded out to a solid and sturdy 30. 10 out of Haywood, thanks to unabated gang wars. One officer down, so I guess you're all screwed, because the NCPD will not let that go.
Mm-mm.
Got another blackout in Santo Domingo. Netrunners are at it again, poking holes in the power grid. While over in Westbrook, trauma teams scraping cyber psycho victims off the pavement. And in Pacifica, well, Pacifica is still Pacifica. This has been your man, Stan. Join me for another day in our city of dreams.
What kind of dreams those would be? Seems like they could be nightmares from some of the images we saw. But awesomely cool nightmares nonetheless. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick. So welcome to this Let's Play. I'm playing this Blind, of course. It just came out like a few hours ago. And I'm going to continue playing it blind through the whole thing. I'm not going to look at any walkthroughs, hints, anything like that. I'm not going to watch gameplay of other people, except for stuff that I might have passed myself. And even then, really, might not do that. So please, no spoilers at all for the entire game. If you haven't seen it in the game, don't talk about it. Like, if I have not fought blah 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 blah, don't talk about blah blah blah, you know, etc. I read all the things, which text on the screen I'm going to read, so hopefully people don't mind that. If you do, well, sorry. I notice I have two press space to continues. I had a bit of trouble getting this even started. I had to rebind the up and down keys in the config file because I couldn't bind them by default. Yeah, I use like a tactical board to control rather than keyboard. Tactical board and mouse. This song is awesome. We are breaching. So I'm just going to quickly show you my settings. Some people might be interested in that. I have the volume all the way up, so hopefully that's good. I mean, the menus might be a lower volume than the rest of the game, so this is subject to change. I am using headphones. Just listen to the difference. Actually, really can only listen to hear a difference with that. But I don't know, because you guys might not be listening to me with headphones, so maybe have it keep it on studio reference for you guys. I don't know. It doesn't sound like a huge difference, but it might be sometimes. I had to do this, which is unfortunate, disable the copyrighted music so that I won't get, you know, copyright claims on YouTube. It's gonna make things easier. Otherwise, I've kept all this stuff the same. And then controls. Right, I'm not using a controller, so skip that. Gameplay. Basically, this, as far as I can remember, all this stuff is the same. I think the crowd density was medium. I turned it to high, so if it starts to affect my performance, I'll turn that down. And possibly other things. Yes, all subject to change. Because I have not played this, really. I've just really just took a little peek into the character creation where you know, assemble your face and stuff like that, and that's it. That's all I've seen. Unfortunately, I have to turn the sensor on as well for YouTube, so which kind of bums me out, because I'd like to hear the copyright music and see the sexy time, but yeah. My default experience will have to be with it nudity off and censored music off. Sorry to disappoint, but anyway, that's that. Graphics, this was like set, so this is probably like a preset. It's based on my graphics card. It's gonna get better, guys, so I hope it's not too crappy looking. I'm still only using a GTX 970. That's the one that only has technically 3.5 gigs of fast VRAM and 0.5 of slow or something. So That's as of now, and I'm using an old motherboard, and I'm using an i5 processor, 2550K, I think, is the processor. I have stuff in the works. I have a motherboard coming in tomorrow, should be, when I'm recording this, in basically a day and a half, and I have a new processor coming later today. And as far as the graphics card, well, it's going to be an i7 processor. Unfortunately, I'm not getting an i9 because I want to stay compatible with Windows 7 to play the older games. But you don't hear me go on and on about that. So I had to, you know, compromise there. And this is less money, too. And I'm having a RTX 3060 Ti. Have not found it yet, but I'm on a waiting list of sorts to when one becomes available. So that's going to be the last thing probably that we put in is the graphics card. So then, and things will be even much better. So these are all, I'll be able to bump all this stuff up to like ultra for at least most things and turn the ray tracing on. I even hear that people with these RTX cards are having performance issues with the ray tracing on. So most likely not their card, but you know, the game needs to be optimized properly for ray tracing. Just what I've heard. And this, yeah, I turned the VSync on. It was off. Maximum FPS. Oh really? Drag it. Maximum FPS 60. Alright. Change that right now. And yeah, this was all the same. So I think we don't have to apply. So, okay, of course, English. Interface. Yeah, I left this all the same. Pretty interesting. Stamina and oxygen. Boss health. I mean, for immersion, you could turn this stuff off. Definitely, there's a case for that. Ammo counter you need. Crosshair job tracker. All this stuff on. Colorblind is actually, if you're colorblind, you can actually fix that. I don't think I've ever seen that in the game before. Crowds on mini map turned off because it affects the CPU performance, and I only have an i5 processor. So key bindings. I think that was already off and just left it off. I don't even know what this is. No spoilers, please. So I didn't change anything here. zoom in, fine. But this is where things get different because I use a tactical board, which has big arrow keys on it. So, and it's basically set up. If you Google Thrustmaster tactical board and go into Google Images or something like that, you'll see what it looks like. It's pretty neat. I really prefer it over... It's like... I don't know. It's like a bigger keyboard with less keys. And a different layout. So, yeah, you have crouch. I prefer to hold to sprint and toggle crouch. I don't know if that's weird, but... And a lot of this other stuff I left the same. And we actually have vehicle stuff, so I changed this. Hope I remember some of these keys. Some of them I changed, some I did not. But anyway. So this game, this episode, I have a feeling this is all going to be character creation. I might be wrong. It might not take that long. It's probably going to take me that long. New game. Difficulty level. Combat will not pose a challenge. I'm going this. Enemies will have all the tools at their disposal to take V on. That's the name of the protagonist you play. But primarily, only enemies at a higher level will prove a challenge. Primarily. Combat will be a substantial challenge on hard. Perks, cyberware, combat gadgets, and consumables will be essential. Very hard. Buckle up for a serious challenge. Careful character development, clever use of items, game mechanics, and environment would be necessary. This would be good for, like, either of these would be good for, like, a second playthrough for me, but... Not that I'm saying I'm going to put it up on YouTube, but... but we're gonna go normal. Night City Resident Database. Now this reminds me of the beginning of the first Mass Effect. Select V's life path. Some events and dialogue options in the game will be different depending on your choice. I forgot to say, the beginning, the radio announcement reminds me a lot of this old movie from 1990, I think it was called Hardware. It's a really cool movie. Check it out sometime. It's, again, set in the future in a dystopian thing. So I'm a dystopian environment, society, whatever you want to call it. And the radio announcer was played by Iggy Pop, and his name was Angry Bob. The man with the industrial, well, you know. Really good movie. But anyway, that reminded me of that, and this reminds me of Mass Effect. So we got Nomad, roaming the Badlands, looting scrapyards, raiding fuel depots. Life on the road wasn't easy, but growing up in a nomad clan has its perks. Honesty, integrity, and a love of freedom. Qualities that few in Night City possess, and no amount of money can buy. That's like a cross between like Rage and Fallout games. Street Kid. They say if you want to understand the streets, you gotta live them. Gangs, fixers, dolls, small-time pushers, you were raised by them all. Down here, the law of the jungle dictates the weak serve the strong. The only law in Night City you have yet to break. It's pretty bleak. And then Corpo. Few leave the corporate world with their lives. Fewer still with their souls intact. You've been there. You've bent the rules, exploited secrets, and weaponized information. There's no such thing as a fair game, only winners and losers. What's it say down here? The data you entered at a... Well, I can't even see that. Night City, at Night City PD Terminal? Does that say R? RD? Will only be used for the purpose you entered them. Your personal data will be protected in accordance with the 2025 Privacy Act. Oh, it's coming up. 2032 Government Act and the Federal Records Act. In accordance with the GMB memo, blah blah, guidelines for the use of net connected devices and personalization procedures, federal agencies have permission to access cookies used in session. I love it. These, to me, these all have their, they all have, they're all appealing in one way or the other. This is the whole Mad Max Fallout type thing, right? And then Street Kid is appealing to me as well. You're in with the gangs, you're down on the streets, you've had, probably have some street cred with them, or just street cred in general. And I'm sure, you know, you're at odds with, you know, if you're a street kid, you're at odds with Nomad and Corpo, vice versa, you know, all. And then corporate world. This is interesting to me as well. I wonder what happened. I guess it's like a maybe a fall from grace, because I don't think you start out with all these corporate contacts. Maybe you do. So I think out of all these, I think the Corpo would be the less picked. So just, they all appeal to me. It's hard to decide. So on the basis of that, I think this might be the least picked one, just to make it an interesting playthrough. Maybe that a lot of YouTubers, you know, haven't put up. It's in the minority. I'll choose Corpo. Select V's body type. V's appearance may sometimes affect the behavior of other characters. We're gonna be female. But of course, in Night City, looks are everything. Okay, so presets, we go from here. This is like, oh yeah, Q&E. This is your protagonist, or female protagonist on the promotional material. She looks pretty much like that. Oh, I looked at that one already. This one. Oh my god. So what's this? Why? Oh, she looks spooky. Look at that. She's like snarls. Why does this one look all weird? You know? Why does it... Is that an error? Other characters were referred to V with female pronouns, i.e. she, her. That makes sense. Voice tone.
I'm V.
Haha, no.
I'm V.
I'm V.
Oh, so there's only two.
I'm V.
So there's only two voices. Okay. Makes sense. I don't know, is your character voiced throughout the game? Skin tone. Oh. Putting the knight back in Night City. I keep trying to drag her, like you would drag Shepherd. Okay. So hairstyle. Okay. Reminds me of like Linda Hamilton kind of hairstyle from Terminator. Is it moving me? No. Okay. Now that looks like the other one. The bottom one here. I don't know. Oh my god. Really? Could you imagine? That's a lot of hair. That is... See, sometimes I move up. It's moving me up randomly. Even though I'm trying to keep the cursor down the hairstyle. This is a liability in a melee fight. Definitely. Or any kind of... Anything where hair can get caught. Jumping around, climbing. That's a definite liability. I kind of like this. I kind of like that too. Oh my god. They really like to have the hair shaved. I like that. Yeah, that's pretty good. Have I gone back around? Yeah. Actually, I don't think I have now. Might be boring, right, without the shaved hair, but... And no hair. Now I think we're back, yeah. So you have this... What's the difference? Just fuller on the bottom? Oh, it's just more poof in the back. This hair is fuller then. And the way it's parted. It's the same. Alright. I'll go with this. I kind of like this hair color, but we might change it. Oh, you can really go out. That's cool. Okay. Yeah, we're going purple hair. That's purple and pinkish. Wow. I just want to experiment with these kind of hair colors in real life. But... Alright. That's the hair color. Eyes? Oh, we're zooming in. Okay. So if you're gonna zoom in, it's pretty helpful. Is this changing... The eye color's next. Oh my god, look at how there's a pause and her whole face like morphs. Oh, it's freaky. Oh my god, the eyes are lopsided. Am I still seeing new eyes? Or I think I am. This was the delay. The delay was all this. They were working on different eyes. We need 3 more weeks to work on the eyes, people. Oh, well, I switched down to color, my mistake. I didn't mean to do that. I didn't know it was there. No. When you zoom out, it looks different. You can't see the forest or the trees. Kind of effect. Zoom back out. And I'm so okay. Yeah, we'll stick with that. Okay. And then eye color. Oh my god. X is for eyes? A target. Yeah, shoot here. That's a great idea. Put a target. Oh my god, mesmerizing eyes. Spider web eyes. Oh my god. That's scary looking. I think I would just want normal eyes. Cat eyes, though. Zoom back out. That's pretty cool looking. Okay. I might stick with these cat eyes. Oh my god. Can you imagine walking around with eyes like that? Like contacts? People would look at your face and just see heart eyes. Oh my god. She's undead. Oh yeah, this is like a lens. Like a camera lens or mechanical shutter kind of thing. Blue. Should I go for cat eyes? Cat eyes. Oh yeah, but definitely this is the whole episode. I assume I can take this stuff off. Alright, where's the cat eyes? Second cat eye. I mean, it looks cool, but she doesn't look completely like an alien. At least I don't think so. Just slightly. Eyebrows. 07. You know, I haven't even noticed the numbers. We started with 7. No. I think 7 was fine. It's like too thin, right? I gotta see how it looks zoomed in and out. Okay, so 1 is pretty good. I like 7 too. We started out 7 the default. Do we go more? We go 8. No eyebrows. Oh, off? Okay. Yeah, I'll stick with the regular eyebrows. Okay. Eyebrow color. green eyebrows. So with black eyebrows, yeah. Do they get even more blacker? It looks like that's it. Okay. And then nose. I'm a nose number one. I might, oh god. I might just stick to nose number one. That one's not bad though. That's a subtle difference. It's just a little down. Yeah, that's even better, actually. Oh my god. Nine. How many noses? Oh my god, we got 20 noses. 21, actually. Some of them are ridiculous. What was the other one I said I liked? Eight. Six. And I think we started at one though, right? I think I might like six a little better. Sorry if anyone finds this boring, but that's why it might be good to just have a whole video of this so you guys can just skip it and be like, see a cutscene or a dialogue scene and be like, yep, that's what character looks like. And I said I liked six. That's a little... I learned the hard way from my Mass Effect playthrough. Always look at the nose from the side as well. Actually, that's pretty cute. That's cuter in the... Yeah. Because to me, that might look slightly better. You know, looking head on, but for a profile, not really. This is I guess better. Oh, maybe not. It's a little too much up, right? So picky. All right, let's just go from. That's a cute little nose, kind of. That's messed up. So I want to make a nose that looks okay from either angle. So nose number two, maybe? To me, the nostrils look too big. I can't with this. That's five. And that's, yeah, that's a little too much. I don't know. Yeah, I think we'll stick with this one. Okay, so mouth, we're already on one. Eh, not bad. So far, I like still liking one the most. I can see her teeth a little. Oh, like that, and then okay. She looks like someone I used to know, actually. Then I Yeah. How many mouths do we have? 20 as well? 21 or something like that? 21, yeah. Kind of like that one, about 16. It's hard to know why you really like what you like. It's just... It's thin, but you know, it's funny, you can't choose the nose size. I would make the nose a little smaller. I don't think she's cute. So is how we look. Okay. Jaw. How many jaws do we have? We have 21 jaws. We have 21 jaws. That you really have to see from the side as well, right? Yeah. I think I'll just stay with the default one. Oh my god. Flat jaw. This one's pretty good too. That's 7. Six. Zoom back out. Yeah. Alright. I'm feeling it. I'm feeling it. Cyberware. That changes the little things around. I prefer something a little less obtrusive, like that. How many cyberwares do we have? Are we almost done with them, actually? Or just completely off? Alright, so we got this, just a little thing up there. And then we got just on the neck. You can't really see it all unless you go zoom out. Okay. Huh. Gives you the ability to scream sonic blast at people. That'd be cool. But this is just cosmetic right here. This gives me that idea. Alright, I am just gonna go for the tiny little forehead thing. There we go. Facial scars off. Facial tattoos. Let me just peek at these. I'm not gonna have scars. Oh my god, all over. What would cause that? It's like your face got buried into something like a texture. Almost reminds me of like tire treads, but not really, you know? Yeah, I'm not gonna have any of these. There's quite a few of them. 9 of them? Facial tattoos. Lethal? Eh. I'm not gonna have any of these either, I'm pretty sure. I thought those were bats or something. Oh god, no. Born to Kill. NUSA? NUSA or something? And then off. Now this... How do I can't just zoom out. I have to go like this to zoom out. It's a little tattoo just on her neck. I wonder if there's gonna be hair physics, like the hair would blow back and we could see it. I mean, I could look at it by just changing the hair. Like, where is it? Hairstyle. I'm on 32. Okay, so if I want to really look at it... It's like a flower. That's a really cute hair color, too. I mean, hair style. I mean, maybe... I like the bangs, but with longer hair, it's the thing. Oh, I had 32, right? Let me just... Because with this face, I feel the shorter hairstyles look pretty nice. More appealing to me, personally, than on the other model. Yeah, I find her pretty appealing, actually. Oh my god. She looks a lot younger to me than the default character. Here. It's probably because of the way I made the nose and mouth and chin, I guess. And with that hairstyle, it's banging too. I like that too. What are we like, 5? We were originally 32. That, I like the bangs are too short. These I don't like. Oh my god, no. That's cute. I'm so undecided. Did I just click something? I don't know. I don't think so. It keeps moving me. My cursor. See, now it flips me up. I think when I... Yeah, if I start going into a full rotate... Oh, only with Q. See that? Now I go this way, it stays. I go Q. Yeah. So maybe not use Q, just use E to change around. I like that too. And you can see the tattoo more. 14... That's nice, though. I'm so undecided. Wish you could change hair in the middle of the game. Drawn back and shaved. I don't remember seeing this hairstyle. It looks different on this character, I think. Don't press Q. Was nice too. All right, so I'm sorry, guys, I can't decide. Would I say 16? And something before that? It looks like this just out of the shower look. I like that. Alright. So you can see the tattoo. There's a good reason. Well, you can see it a little better with this. Guys, just feel free to skip ahead and preview the video. I can't decide. I don't want it to be one of these first ones. 16. Which one was I looking at that I kind of don't want to go for the shave thing. I don't know. Yeah, 16. 16. The hell with it. I do like the other shorter. That is a little bit shorter than the others. Alright. And you can kind of see the tattoo, some of it anyway. So piercings. Oh, what is she doing? Growling? What piercings does she have now? She has ear piercings, I guess, with this. Yeah, I see them. You can't really see. 11. I don't like too much. Where do we start? We were on 11. Yeah, just keep it on 11. Piercing color. Can't really see him though. I like that noise. Gold. Gold earrings. Sure. Teeth? Oh my god! She bared her teeth. Oh. You gotta keep them open. Pink teeth. I think I'm gonna keep them just the same. Eye makeup. Wow. You don't have to keep showing me your teeth. I'm past that. Do I like that? Wait. Kind of. I like the top more. No. Nah. No. That's pretty rad. Alright, we've circled back around. I think I like this, and I'll probably just keep it basic black. Let's zoom out. I don't know, is it too much? Wait. You know, if it's too much, just change the color. Eye makeup color. More of a brownish? No, not that. Not that. Not that. And then we can also go like... Does this just change it to the same ones? I think so. I think it's more of them. More different ones? I'm not sure. You know, if I make it like a little less drastic. I kind of want just basic, you know, and they don't have basic. 7, 8. There's 8. See, I want some more on the bottom, though. That's the problem. Ugh. And that has some on the bottom, but it has a lot more on the top. I'll go with this. No. I don't like it. I mean, I kind of like it, but it's just too much for that face. And where do we change the freckles and stuff? Blemishes? Is that... Oh, we got blemishes. Wait. Off. No, that's not blemishes. Oh. So she's still got some, though. So I guess that's not all. Hello. This is the part where you'd see her naked if I didn't turn that off, right? God damn it, YouTube. skin tone. Is that part of skin tone, though? No, she's got them no matter what. Is that what we had it on? I think. I mean, her eyes look cool, but it just takes away... I feel like she's got like a natural look that just the eye makeup is just like drowning it out. So I might actually turn it. I'm gonna either really minimalize it or turn it off completely. Because I don't like the other colors. I'd go for a more natural brown. What's the color? Wait a second. I think I'll just go with this. Zoom back out. Skin type. Maybe it's skin type. Oh, yes. She changes. Oh my god. Wait, it all has that. She's got this no matter what. 4. Oh, I think she was on this, right? 1. I think she's on 1, right? I messed with it. I don't think she was on this, but I'm gonna have her on this. Right? Does she look weird? But this is just dark, like... Her face is like, looks like it has darker makeup than the rest of her skin, like the rest of her body. 5. Here looks like it matches the rest of her skin better. I'm not sure if that's how I had it. Okay, piercing color, teeth, eye lip makeup. And this. I see, that's a lot lighter than it looks there to me. Alright, let's keep it like this, and then makeup? Hell no. Lip makeup color, though. Oh, we can. Yeah, I'd go for something natural, more natural like that. I'm not sure what I'm doing with it, but. Alright, so far, yeah, one. Oh, I changed. That's off. Okay. So one. Cheek makeup. That's where you change that. Okay, I could turn it off, and she's got this little. That's part of her stuff, her whatever you call it, her cyberware. Wow, this is gonna be a long episode. It already is a long episode. Lip makeup. So that's with nothing. That's with this stuff. Okay, and then color, we've got redder, if you go like this is more though, oh wait, no, that's, you decide to have it like that, okay. Yeah, okay. Blemishes, just curiosity. Yeah, I'm just gonna have them off. How many are there? There's three. Blemishes off. Nails. Very short. Long. Okay, long. Nail color. Have we ever seen a game where you can change your nail color? Fire. It's hard to, it's not as easy to tell from this what they would look like. That's pretty cool looking. Too bad we can't zoom in on them. I guess we're never gonna see them really up close though. That kind of goes with the hair, sort of, though. There's like nail art and stuff. Probably have get laser printed right onto your real nails. I think I might just go for that one that goes kind of with the hair color a little. Is that one? Yeah. Okay. Nails and nail color, body tattoos. Is it? Is there more stuff? Oh my god. The tattooed lady. We have five versions. I mean, if I go like this, and then I zoom back to regular, you can see it, yeah. And if you go... This is like not ultra zoomed out, but... Yeah, okay. Why not? Body scars? No. You have two different things. Where's the scar? Is it under the tattoos, maybe? I can't see anything happening with the scars. Like, where am I supposed to be looking? Alright, so... Next. Okay, character skills. Finally, choose the core attributes you want to begin with. Each attribute contains a set of skills. Both attributes and skills provide different bonuses depending on your style of play. Skill levels increase as you perform activities associated them. Of course. So it's your, basically like your Elder Scrolls thing. The more you use a skill, the more you go up. Limited by the level of the attribute. Okay, so body determines your raw physical power. In addition to allowing you to force open doors, each level of body will add 5 health points, 3 stamina points, damage with fists and gorilla arms, increased damage with melee weapons, decreased movement penalty while grabbing an enemy and wielding an HMG. What is that? Increased movement while grabbing... I have 10 points, okay. Intelligence determines your net running proficiency. Every level of intelligence will increase cyberdeck RAM capacity, quick hack damage, and quick hack duration. Alright. Sounds like it could be important. Reflexes determine your maneuverability. In addition to increasing your overall movement speed, each level of reflexes will increase your passive evasion from enemy attacks, increase crit chance, increased damage from mantis blades. All those things that come out your arm. Technical ability represents your technical know-how. It allows you to unlock doors and use tech weapons. Each increase in level will increase your armor by 5%. And then cool. Your resilience, composure, and effectiveness in operating from stealth. Every level of cool will increase crit damage, all resistances, stealth damage by 10%. That is going to be noticeable. 10% for every level. Reduce the speed at which enemies detect you in stealth by a small amount. 0.5%. Increase mono wire damage, whatever that is, by 3. I'm guessing this is all of them and it's not something else on the next page. So I'm starting off at 3 with everything. I want to be good with stealth. And technical ability. I want to be pretty good. Reflexes. And intelligence. This, less so. I mean, health is always good. Stamina is always good. Crit chance, though. These two together would work really well because it increases your crit chance and this increases your crit damage. And then stealth damage, so crit from stealth, boom. Unlock doors and use tech weapons. Increase your... See, the crit chance is only by 1%, though. This is very slight. Damage from mantis blades, if you're interested in that. Undecided myself. Increase passive evasion. How about 6 here? I'll leave this the same. I might regret it. Body. And Should we increase our cyberdeck RAM capacity? This seems really minor. Unless you're interested in man displays, maybe by 3 is really good for that. I don't know. Increase your armor. So the increase only increases your armor, not your unlocking doors and tech weapons? Well, that's max level, 6. Let's put this to 3, put that to 5, and that to 5. That's what we'll do. So we're gonna be really stealthy, with good stealth damage. Mono wire damage is gonna be pretty good, whatever that is. And yeah, resistance is crit, slightly better. Technical ability, armor is gonna be better. Unlocking doors, tech weapons. This is gonna be just as it is. Can we can't decrease it from that. 3 is the minimum. All right. Oh, that's why it says minimum level, max level. Got it. And intelligence. Wait. Intelligence. Yeah, RAM capacity. Alright. So begins your story in Night City. Alias. V. Backstory. Corpo. Few leave the corporate world with their lives, fewer still with their souls intact. You've been there, you've bent the rules, exploited secrets, and weaponized information. I think that says that already. In the beginning. There's no such thing as a fair game, only winners and losers. Yeah, it's the biometric data. Alright. Confirm.